Leo. What you doing out here?
Just looking at the moon. It's really big tonight.
I just saw your new soccer trophy. Very cool.
I didn't win the trophy. We lost every match, and I played terrible. Everyone got one for participating.
Well, at least it looks good. Bigger than most of my trophies.
Yeah, I guess, but honestly, it makes me feel weird. Trophies are good, but I don't feel like I earned it. My coach said we should feel good because we tried, so I guess I should be proud, but I don't know.
Yeah, it is a little weird to get a trophy when you lose.
You're so good at sports, you almost never lose. I'm starting to think competition just might not be my thing.
Leo, competition is good for you, and it might not feel like it, but losing is actually good for you too.
Why would losing ever be a good thing?
Life's famous winners started with losses.
Like who? Yeah, let's go!
Let's see.
Layla, we're in outer space.
Leo, I think we're on the moon. Was my phone listening to us? You just were talking about the moon. This can't be right.
I don't like where this computer's taking us. I'm gonna take over and land us manually.
Neil! Do we have enough fuel? We're almost out!
I got this.
Woo! We did it! USA! USA! USA!
The Eagle has landed.
Leo, aliens?
Either aliens or astronauts.
OMG! This is incredible! We won!
Buzz, Buzz, easy. I'm gonna go out there and fulfill the mission.
Okay. I'll get everything else ready.
That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Ah! Aliens!
No. We're not aliens. We're Leo and Layla from the future. We thought you might be aliens.
Ah.
Well, we're American astronauts. I'm Neil Armstrong, and Buzz Aldrin is in the lunar module. It's the summer of 1969. What are you doing here?
We're trying to learn about competition, and for some reason, our time machine delivered us here. It might have made a mistake.
Uh-huh. Actually, you're in the perfect time and place. I don't mean to sound boastful, but you've just witnessed one of the greatest victories in history. A victory for the USA, but also a victory for mankind.
You getting here to the moon?
Yep. Let me tell you about it. After the massive destruction of World War II, the two most powerful countries were the United States of America and the Soviet Union.
Is the Soviet Union the same thing as Russia?
Close. Russia's been around for hundreds of years. But in the year of 1917, a group of people called the Communists took it over. These Communists called themselves Soviets, and the new country they set up was called the Soviet Union. Over the years, the Soviets expanded their territory and took over many countries. It can be confusing, but just think of Russia as being the biggest country inside the communist-led Soviet Union.
Okay, gotcha.
And we know from our trip to see President Reagan that communism is a system of government that oppresses people and makes life terrible.
Whoa. Ronald Reagan, the actor, became president?
Yeah, a really good one too.
Well, it sounds like President Reagan taught you well. Communism is very bad. And for the last 25 years, we Americans have been in a battle to stop it. One of the biggest parts of the battle has been a competition for global influence.
Influence? Is that like when my mom says to be a good example for Leo?
It's pretty similar. In this competition for influence, America wants to show the world a way of life where people are free is better than the communist way of life where people are controlled by their government.
What does you and Buzz coming to the moon have to do with it?
In this competition, we want to show that the American way of life produces better athletes, better art, better food, better everything. That includes better technology. And there's no better demonstration of technology than space exploration. We and the Soviets have been competing for years now to see who can win the space race. And until today, we kept losing.
America? Losers? No way. How?
First, we competed to see who could get a satellite into space. They won. Then the communists were the first to get a living creature into space. And then the really big one, the Soviets beat us into getting a man into space. We've had so many failures over the years, but we never gave up.
Were the failures devastating?
Did you get a participation trophy?
Nope, I didn't need one of those. And look, no one likes to fail, but it's the part of life that leads to success.
Are you saying it's good to lose?
It's the pain of losing that drives a person to improve. So the road to victory is paved with losses. Without our losses in the space race, we wouldn't be standing on the moon today.
That's why it's so great when you have a coach who pushes you to be a winner.
After our losses, we were never rewarded or consoled. In fact, after the Soviets got the first man into space, the guy who was sort of like our coach, President John F. Kennedy, challenged our entire nation to work, to improve, and to do the unthinkable. JFK challenged America to be the first to put a man on the moon.
But why, some say, the moon? Why choose this as our goal? We choose to go to the moon not because it is easy, but because it is hard. It is a goal that will organize our energy and skill. It is a challenge we are willing to accept and one we intend to win.
It sounds like President Kennedy was a good coach.
He certainly was a great motivator. He persuaded the government, private business, and every American man, woman, and child to make sacrifices and work together. And in under 8 years, here we are. We won.
This makes me proud to be an American.
Me too. What an accomplishment.
What are you going to do when you get back to Earth? Won't everything be boring compared to this?
I fell in love with the world of flight as an elementary student, and I got my pilot's license at the age of 16.
What? That's just a few years older than me.
I even flew 78 missions during the Korean War, and now I'm the first man to walk on the moon. I want to teach people about airplanes and how they fly. Maybe I can even help students learn from their losses on the way to victory.
Neil, you've got a call. It's the president.
Well, kids, it's been nice talking to you, but I've got to get back to work.
Of course, Mr. Armstrong. It's been an honor to meet you.
Yeah, thanks to you and all the other Americans that made this happen.
Hello, Mr. President. Thank you.
You feel better?
Yeah.
Going to keep competing?
Totally. If I get more participation trophies, no problem. I'm not going to let trophies of any kind affect me. I'm just going to work to get better. If I turn my weak foot into a strength, I'll be really tough to stop.
Love it. Let's get home.
Hey, Buzz. Are you ready to get out of here?
I can't believe I forgot the golf clubs.
To all the people that are listening and watching tonight, God bless you. Good night from Apollo 11.
If you are interested in time traveling again, please subscribe to PragerU.com/kids and watch more of our adventures.